Corridors and rooms usually filled with people lie empty and silent. The Devil's Porridge Museum in Eastriggs normally offers visitors an insight into the largest munitions factory in the world during the First World War. But while the museum may have closed its doors to the public, many of its exhibitions have gone digital for people to enjoy from their own home.
So we had a series of great talks coming up, so once a month, a sort of history or local interest talk. We've turned that into a podcast. We've also taken our book bug sessions. He's now taken that online and does it via Facebook Live, which has also proven very popular. It is sad seeing something that you're working very hard to raise the profile of and try and get people aware of it and visiting it. It's quite tough to see it shut down. We just have to go along with it, and anything that we've planned, we can postpone and rearrange.
Staff want to keep up public engagement and share the museum's story.
Although we're closed, it's important we get the message about how Eastriggs and Gretna were created in the First World War for the greatest munitions factory on earth. That's our job, is to tell that story. So it's important that we keep that going online. So if you go back to the First World War, the women who came here, the 12,000 women that came here, they were doing their bit for the country, just like the NHS workers are doing their bit for the country now.
In Carlisle, Tully House is also keeping connected to the public. The museum is asking for photos that will help tell the coronavirus story and what it was like during lockdown to future generations.
We think it's really important as a museum that we can collect and tell those stories so that in the future we can partly help people come to terms with it and help people sort of work through it, but also then in the future be able to look back on this period and tell people about it and talk about it.
This would normally be a key time for the museum with high visitor numbers.
We were doing really well before lockdown in terms of visitor numbers, and we would have seen that accelerate over this nice period within April and May, and so it's very, very difficult. You know, one of the major roles of the museum is community engagement, and so, you know, we do a lot of work with young people, we do a lot of work with old people, and they're missing that opportunity to socialise and to be inspired by museum collections, and they're the people that I really feel for.
Like all businesses, museums are finding ways to adapt, sharing their stories until they can open their doors once again. Jennifer Cordingley, ITV News, Carlisle.